Next, we have date data types. Of course, you need dates inside the database, because without dates, how will you store the hire date, the end date, the notice period, the joining date, date of birth, and a lot of other types of dates. You need to have date in order to perform the date operations, right? So one data type for date is date itself. All dates include century, year, month, date, hour, minute, and second. So what is the meaning of this one? So guys, by default, when you query your database, see, select sysdate from dual. If you run this query, the problem is you are only getting the date as the output, but inside your database, all dates, whenever you try to store, it will store the century, the year, the month, the date, the hour, minute, second, all those values. Okay, so how do you see it? I'm pretty sure about the SQL star plus, but I'm not sure about SQL developer. Let us run this command. This is only for your understanding purpose, because this command is good for Oracle DBAs, but for the certification purpose, you don't need to understand about this command. So you need to alter the session, set NLS date format is equal to DDMM. Whatever format you specify, your dates will always be printed in this format from all the tables. Then I want 24 hours format, and then minutes, then seconds. And let me execute this one. Okay, session is altered, right? Now let me try to query this as date. Now can you see, we have the entire date. This is 1st December 2018, and this is the current system time. The same thing you can see in the hr.employees table. So select hire date from hr.employees. And now we'll run this query. You see, because in our session, we are telling Oracle to always print the dates in this format. Let's take, you want the format under 12 hours format. So alter the session, rather than 24, make it 12 hours. And then run this query. Can you see, all the hire dates are now printed with the 12-hour format. So what is the one learning that you have? All the dates that you input, it will actually store the entire value for your time and date. It's not only the date. It will also by default store the time. And to enable the time, you have to change the format for your session as the way how dates are output on your screen. If you use this kind of query, it will change the output on the screen. Next, we have timestamp. Takes the sysdate time when you insert the value. While you are trying to insert a record, rather than any value, you specify the timestamp. So whenever you are trying to insert the record, it will automatically take the system time. It will print the system time. So whatever your system time is, it will be inputted into the column value. Now, why do we need system time? It's very important when it comes to transactional database in banking. Whenever you try to debit some amount, credit some amount, there is always a timestamp column which will automatically take the system time when the transaction was performed. This column comes handy in lot of banking transactions. Okay, so this is very important column, because see, every time when you are inserting a record, you do not want to insert the date and time. You want automatically system to take whatever the system time is, because we want to record the exact transaction time. So that's why Oracle also provides a timestamp column. Whatever value you are trying to insert, it will automatically insert the system time into the column value, so that you don't have to specify it again and again.